Hey guys! Welcome back to Let's Play World of Warcraft. And in today's episode, we will be doing a special for the dungeons. It's finally time to take on dungeons. So, the first thing you want to know is if you want to pull up the dungeons information, you hit I on your keyboard. Just being specific here. When you first bring it up, you'll have this random classic dungeon option. And you can use this if you want to, but I'm gonna go in the specific order, so I won't be using this. You get money out of it and experience when you're done with the thing, and you get a satchel of helpful goods. This is good for you if you are starting your first character. Me specifically, I'm going to be doing the specific dungeon. I'm going to be doing the dead mines. Now, we are in a tank. If we were using our bear form as our main animal of choice, we would be using a tank. If we were a healer, we would be using the healing status. And if you're a moonkin slash balance, or if you are the tiger, you would be using DPS. Now that's the one thing about the World of Warcraft universe, is for at least druids, there are a few others, you can use all of these if you want. But you have to be the right class to use the right one. It just gives you the option because you're a druid and druids can potentially use them all. This indicates that you are an experienced player and are comfortable instructing the group on how to overcome the encounters. Me personally, I've never specifically been very good at the dead mines, so I shouldn't have exited out of that, and I'm not gonna hit that. Down here you want to hit find group and it'll put you in the queue. Me personally, I don't know how long that's gonna take because it can take any different amount of time. So I'm going to head over to the crossroads again, where we were in the last episode before we came to Ratchet. And hopefully between now and then I will get it, but if not, I'll cut to when we get there. So I will see you guys in a minute. So guys, we are at the crossroads. It's not time to do the dungeon yet, but just so that you have an idea in case for later, you can use this. It says how many of each you get that are queued in so far. I actually don't go by this because I think it's false. So I wouldn't go by it. It shows the amount of time you've been queued in and all that stuff. So, I mean, that's a good thing to note. It's just this little green circle that's right here. So no worries. But yes, I will come back when we are queued in. Okay guys, so finally we got the dungeon. Yes. Oh, I have a feeling they might be in the middle of the dungeon if it was that easy to get in. But we'll see. Let's see what happens. No, I don't have my Mark of the Wild equipped on the screen. I should probably do that. Okay, load much. Let's see. Do I not have Mark of the Wild? Apparently not. That's good to know for later. So this is basically the dungeon. So that's what happens when you don't have, when you lose your internet. And when you lose your way, it's even better. Man. So dark.
Gloom Talk show you the power of the arcane. Fists of Flame.
Alright. So, this is our first major boss in this level. We are all damaged. Lovely. I mean, there's really nothing to say. He is a pain. But he's basically one of those bosses where you can sit here and just wail on him. Unless you run out of energy like me. And now he's dead. I'm just gonna pass on all the loot, because I don't need it. It's not interest to me. This is a dungeon. You're with a bunch of other players, basically. They can be from other realms. These people come from other realms. I don't think any of these people are from my realm. Which is fine. I'm still gonna pass, because I don't care about any of this stuff. Fighting this guy? Are we not? Okay, there we go. Okay, the one problem that you could have with auto-attacking is make sure you're attacking the right thing, because I keep targeting all these barrels. And I know you don't want to attack the barrels. Attacking me. I'm just gonna sit here and press this button and be like, lala. Oh look, we leveled. Did we level? I can't tell. And apparently I was drunk for a minute there. Okay, no, it was the person next to us that leveled. So that's fine. There's a little goblin dude. Do we need a warrior? Okay, I guess we're not fighting the goblin dude. So, just attacking. I'm sorry that my commentary's not that great, but I mean, there's nothing really to say about these guys. I mean, it's basically you just mangle and attack them and attack and mangle. But you do have to work as a team to some degree. Like, as a DPSer, I can't. Oh. And this. Oh man, this is gonna be fun. This is the next boss, by the way. You have to kill his lackeys before you can actually kill him. Man, people are just leveling right and left. That's awesome, though. Yeah, you definitely don't want to trigger the one. This is the boss right here. You don't want to trigger him yet. You want to get kicked out of the guild, or out of the group, you could trigger him now. With these early bosses, usually if you attack them quick enough, you won't have an issue, but I've seen some problems with this guy, so just make sure that your group knows what they're doing, and you shouldn't have a problem, so... Yeah, see, he's already, like, going down. There you go. Now, it's this guy that could be a problem. You gotta make sure you stay away from these mines. And this is something to keep into consideration when you're doing, like, oh god. What happened with these two? You definitely don't want to stay near the mines. Just trust me on that one. They will eventually go off, so you just want to kind of be careful, because that could end you really quickly. But, luckily we were kind of lucky there, and none of them managed to go off. No. Okay, they were glowing like I needed them for a quest, and I was like, what? Pretty sure that wasn't a quest on this one, but, so anyways, the tips that I give you, they are good to keep in mind for, like, when you get into a higher level, these dungeons will come back as heroics, and basically, heroics are very unforgiving. I've played this one as heroics, and I hate it. I hate this one on heroics, because it is so hard. Like, I can't even explain how hard it is. It makes me want to cry how hard they can be. But yes. Just make sure that you work as a team. You don't want to out-aggro the DPSer. That can happen if you're not careful. I've done it twice since I jumped in here. Luckily, the DPSer is not, or the tank is not being too bad. So, okay, it is the Tauren who's our tank. That's what I thought. So this is the next boss of this dungeon. There are an X amount of set bosses, just so you know. This is setting up for the boss. I believe he's actually over here. Yes, this is him right here. He's the Foe Reaper 5000, and he is a pain. If you're not careful, he will do some serious damage to you, so keep that in mind, because... Like I said, in heroics, he's even more unforgiving than anything. He will kill you in one hit. I've never beaten this dungeon on heroics because, well, there was just a lot of things that kind of caused that one. So, for now... I just kind of want to stand back here and hope and pray. Because I've never... I've never actually beaten this guy. Like, I don't know exactly 100% what you're supposed to do for this guy. If any of you guys do know, You can feel free to tell me, because I will be more than happy to, do it. In-between enemies are just kind of like trash, so you don't have to worry about them. I may stop passing on loot in a minute. I may just greed. I mean, not greed. Yeah, it's greed. It's weird. I don't like the way that they set that up, because one time I accidentally went through a dungeon, like, needing everything, and need, apparently, is over greed. I don't remember exactly. It's always confusing to me. I don't like it. I'm like, which one's which? I don't understand what I'm supposed to do. So, it can be a pain. Let's see, let's check our map. The nice little add-on they added is that you can check your map and it shows like how many more bosses you have to kill and everything. We have 3 more bosses to kill, so just keep that in mind. Now we can continue on when that thing blows up the door. Yeah, it's nice that they did that, especially for the Wailing Caverns, because the Wailing Caverns are a pain in the butt. They are. You guys are probably like, haha, she said the word, but I mean, I am so serious. The pain that you go through for that, if you solo it later, before this was here, I'm sure some people remember, you could easily get lost in the Wailing Caverns. I know you don't have a target, thanks. Oh. Don't go into that. Yeah, these little red marks, don't go on them. That's where the bowling balls hit, and they will hurt you badly. Like, badly. What? I wasn't even attacking you! Man, those parrots are a pain. But dungeons are a good way to level yourself up if you're falling behind. So just keep that in mind in case you ever feel like you're falling behind in levels and you can't keep up. That is a good way to level yourself. Yo, dude. Look at these guys, you got a pole. I mean, I know they're just trash, but can we, like, not do that? I personally have never been a big fan of dungeons. Oh god, I just almost jumped myself right off the edge. That would have been bad. There we go. I don't know who it was targeting, but it wasn't targeting this dude. Oh man, all the funds. Yeah, personally, when I play by myself, I usually don't run the dungeons because it's just annoying to try and wait for them. I feel like you can level faster doing quests than you could running the dungeon, but that's just me. I don't want to attack that cannon. Oh man, this guy is annoying! And you're probably like, oh, he doesn't look that bad. Trust me, he will. He just gets annoying in a little bit. He has this one attack. This one's annoying. I mean, it's not a big pain. I've seen worse, but I mean, this could get annoying. He's just annoying. That's all there is to it. I can smell your stupidity. Oh, target him. Man, this thing just wants to target those pirates down there. That's the only problem with the auto-target, is the target's so funky.
I will rip your heart from your chest.
You try that. You tell me how that works out for you, okay, sir? Man, you are just all kinds of crazy.
Until it is too late.
And now, there we go. I was waiting for someone to walk in there. Man, oh man. This is turning out to be annoying. Sometime today, please. This guy is just, I don't even know what he's supposed to do. Like, is he seriously supposed to be a threat? I don't know. Now I'm going to take your, or turn in these quests. Let's turn in our quests.
Move it!
The quest. Wow. I don't think we're gonna level up. That's so weird. Usually this is the best place to try and level up. Strength and stamina. Oh. I'll throw this away. Yeah.
Strength and honor.
Well, I got an achievement. I got a couple achievements, actually. But let's head out, so let's leave this instance group. And that is all for this episode while this thing loads, because it likes to load. So I think me and Holy Fox are going to take a nap now. So as always, thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one when we cover Ragfire Chase'em. Until then, everyone.